Hey guys, welcome back to Vibrations and Libations. I'm James.
And I'm Keith.
And tonight we're going to be drinking some Kentucky bourbon. And what are we listening to, Keith?
Wolfmother.
Wolfmother. He introduced this album to me, just like a lot of other albums we've done on this channel. And it's a pretty good album. I had never listened to these guys before. And I'm glad he let me borrow the record. So, again, we're going to be drinking some Kentucky bourbon. We're going to be drinking 10-year-old Eagle Rare. And if you've never had this, I hope this video makes you want to go out and buy a bottle of it and drink until it is empty. Share if you want to. That's completely up to you.
As most always, this will be my first time drinking this particular bourbon because I've had maybe this many bourbons.
All right, so what we're going to do tonight while we're listening to this album, talking about it, we're going to drink some bourbon. I'm going to start out drinking some just straight, and then we're going to make some highballs.
Yes.
And we're going to do that with some Canada Dry ginger ale and lemonade. So that'll
maybe not a traditional highball, maybe.
Yeah. What I've read, it's a highball is in a certain kind of glass, which I don't necessarily have, but it's going to drink the same.
Yeah.
And with ginger ale. Ginger ale, lemonade, it's going to work the same.
Yeah.
So, anyway, that's what we're going to do. So, I'm going to let Keith talk about this album a little bit. I'm going to pour some whiskey.
First thing I want to talk about is our new location that we're at.
Yes.
We're not in the cabin tonight. Where are we at, James?
Well, we're at my new house. If you've been following us on Instagram or Facebook, you may have seen some pictures of me setting up this bar, which still isn't finished, but it's going to work for tonight. And my family moved into a new home, and so this is the basement, and I have an entire room right now all to myself for my records and my concert posters that I have, so, and for possible future videos. So I've not called it a man cave yet, but I'm thinking of some good names for it.
Yeah,
maybe the hottie hole, maybe
whatever
the bunker, I don't know. Yeah, but Keith, let's. You want some bourbon, Keith? You want me to pour while you're.
Yeah, don't leave me one quite as heavy.
Oh, okay. I'll give you a lightweight.
All right. So this is Wolfmother's debut album. It debuted in Australia when it originally released on October 31st, 2005. It didn't come out in the U.S. until the following year in 2006, but in Australia it made it all the way to the number 3 on the charts. I believe it only got to number 22 in the U.S. But Joker and the Thief charted the highest. It was their highest charting in Australia. It made it to number 8 on their respective charts. But also, this is the only album which the co-founding members were will be on. The rest of them, it's only Andrew Stockdale. The co-founding members are Andrew Stockdale, who is lead vocalist and guitarist, Chris Ross, who plays bass and the keyboards, and Miles Hesket.
Close enough
on drums.
Sorry if we mispronounced your name there.
Yeah, you're a badass on the drums, man.
That should be good enough for you.
Good enough. I love the cover on this thing.
Oh, yes. It's a beautiful cover. And I don't have an actual record of it out right now, but the label on the record is just awesome. It's like whoever decided on this artwork, they were spot on. I mean, they pulled all the punches to get... pulled no punches, I guess I should say.
Well, it is taken from a piece of art called The Sea Witch by Frank, and I'm going to mess this up too, Frazetta. And another thing to note is Walmart wouldn't sell this, of course, because there's boobies on the front.
Yes.
Can't sell anything with boobies in Walmart.
Right.
And the kids might see the boobies. And,
but they can sell movies
with boobies
in them.
Well, you can't just walk in Walmart and see those movies.
Yeah,
boobies, though.
I guess not.
But I, you know, this record was set out at my house. My kids will see those boobies all day long. I mean, you really can't tell.
It's kind of hard to hide them.
It's a painting, man. It's art.
Exactly.
Anyway, get over it, Walmart. But Walmart sold this album with a plain white logo. with just the band's name on it. So they censored them a little bit.
At least they got the music out.
There's no explicit lyrics in this, but it's excellent lyrics.
Yeah.
All the same. Mm-hmm. I believe Andrew Stockdale is won awards as like lyricist of the year and things like that.
Awesome.
But he's pretty gifted, talented musician.
Yeah. All right. So take you a sip of the bourbon and let's see what you think about it. Get you a good smell. Yeah.
I smell wood, as always.
Of course. Got to smell the wood.
But it does have a little complexity there. A little bit of fruity smell. I can't put my finger on it, on my nose. Put my nose in it.
Once again, we're not professional bourbon tasters, so those of you who may watch this and consider yourself.
Damn! Sucked it right down my throat.
All right, well. Burn going down.
It's so smooth.
It wasn't that fucking smooth.
That shit's not fucking smooth.
All right, so a little bit about the bourbon here. Again, it's Eagle Rare. It's 10-year single barrel. And here's what the old Google box has to say about it. And Keith, after that nice drink, see if you agree with any of this. It says,
Let me give him one drink for you.
Okay.
I'm not going to cough this.
All right.
Okay, all right.
So it says, instead of the dryness and oakiness found in Eagle Rare 17-year-old from Buffalo Trace, they're the ones who make Eagle Rare, Eagle Rare Single Barrel presents you with a sweet and mellow bourbon.
Sweet and mellow.
This shouldn't come as much of a surprise, seeing how comparing a 10-year-old at $29 with a 17-year-old at $80. Now, I would like to say that the liquor store I bought this at, I paid $34 before tax. So, a little high, I guess, where I live at. So, if you can find it any cheaper, please leave some comments and send me a bottle. I wouldn't care if you just sent me one. If you can get it for $29, it ain't going to break you. Just send me a bottle. So, but I personally think that it's one of the smoother bourbons that I've ever drank. It went down Keith's wrong hole, I guess, down the wrong pipe. But
I was trying to be fancy and get the air in with it, kind of like you do wine.
Yeah.
That doesn't work as well with bourbon, in my opinion.
Right.
But I will agree, it's good.
Mm-hmm.
It is sweet.
It is. It does have a sweetness to it.
It is more smooth than other bourbons that I've had. I like it.
Yeah. What about comparing this to Elijah Craig?
Elijah Craig, it's definitely more complex than Elijah Craig.
Yeah.
More flavorful, you know, there's, like I said, sweeter notes to it.
Yeah.
It smells fruity, but it doesn't taste fruity.
Right.
There's no fruity. I mean, it's bourbon straight up. Woody, but sweet.
Yeah. What I like best about this bourbon is after you drink it, the aftertaste, it doesn't leave a burn. It's more of it leaves a sweet.
It is clean.
A sweet kind of taste to it. So, you know, you're not really going to burn yourself up drinking it. So.
Yeah, I feel like I could talk to my wife after this and I wouldn't be breathing bourbon breath all over.
Exactly. So now what I'm going to do is we've got some ice here and I'm going to make a highball. So I've got a nice little glass here. This actually
Are you
going to
make mine too?
I'll make yours too if you want me to.
Should I go around the other side of the bar? I feel so free here, Dave.
we're
usually sitting in the chairs, but I feel like, you know, I need to do some calisthenics or something.
That was,
like, I got this going on. And
that was one of my hopes in having this room and being able to put a bar down here that, you know, if you're sitting in front of it or if you're behind it, you know, you can, have some room to move around. There's plenty of room in this room that we're in. Keith's going downstairs, so.
Yeah, the elevator.
So, I'm gonna pour the ginger ale first, and then I'll put what bit of whiskey I have, because I probably have about a shot left in my glass. And if you want me to make yours, I will.
Yeah, James, make mine.
Let me see you cut.
Are you going to put this one in there? The rest of this?
I'll put the rest of that if you want me to.
All right.
So, again, bourbon drinkers, bourbon aficionados, this is, you know, all for fun. I'm sure there's some kind of technique to making a highball, but really, from what I've read, it's some bourbon, some ginger ale, and, you know.
Can you edit that out?
The cocktail shake?
Yeah,
you want to flip it behind your back and everything? Yeah. I've got a mixing cup over there.
What's this look like, Dave?
You have an ass shaker?
Yeah, I'm shaking. Shake weight.
So I guess we could have made it in this, shook it up, and then poured it out.
Oh, man, that's a nifty little strainer.
Didn't even think about that. I use this for making Cosmos for my wife. All right, Keith, so I wouldn't say bottoms up after what happened earlier.
I'm gonna put one more ice in there.
I like mine sometimes with just some ginger ale and water. If I'm feeling froggy, I'll put some ice in it to get that coldness, but I don't like to put a whole lot of either in it, so.
Give me one of these.
Cheers, brother.
All right, cheers. Hey, man, that's mild on the lemonade.
It is mild on lemonade. One thing I would like to say about mixing these up is if you get the ratio wrong, you're not really going to be able to tell it because the ginger ale kind of cuts the bourbon sting out. And just like with any other kind of cocktail, you're going to drink too much before you know it.
Yeah.
And get flat-faced. Or shit-faced, however you want to say it. But I do like coming home from work and having one of these just kind of unwinding. You know, it's not a bad little drink to have. So sometimes I'm not in the mood just to drink bourbon straight.
Yeah.
So.
This song, Woman, by the way, I don't know if you ever heard it on the radio. When this album was released in the U.S., this was their hit single, okay. Woman. And the album version is different than the radio version.
Oh, really?
It didn't have that nice keyboard banging solo on it and everything.
Cut out for time, you think, or what?
I don't know. It's just a little bit longer. I mean, the song is only 2:56.
Yeah.
2 minutes, 56 seconds long. So I don't understand that because that part's badass.
Right.
Anyway.
So some of the other songs on this album are Where Eagles Have Been, Apple Tree, Joker and the Thief, Colossal, Mind's Eye, Pyramid, Witchcraft, which is my favorite on the album. Love Train, Vagabond, and then Tales, and Tales from the Forest of Gnomes.
Yes, that's something that is different from the American version versus the Australian version. Tales from the Forest of Gnomes, and then just simply Tales.
Yeah.
The U.S. version, it's just Tales. But the Australian release is Tales from the Forest of Gnomes. I guess they think us American guys aren't as out there as they are. But I like that title.
Perhaps they're afraid we'll build a wall for gnomes not to be able to cross.
Maybe.
I don't know.
I won't. Shut that wall down. Let those gnomes out.
Let them out. All right, so as we were getting ready and setting up and everything, Keith was, we were talking about the album, who we, you know, what we compared it to. I compare it a lot to Raconteurs. I think it's got a sound, you know, close to that. Jack White. You said that some people say it's a ripoff of who?
Led Zeppelin. And other than the register that the man sings in,
right.
There is no... I mean, I get the influence, you know, but just the grandeur of the whole thing.
Right.
But, I mean, if you like Led Zeppelin, you'll probably like them, but, you know, it's not the same.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think of primarily Led Zeppelin whenever I think of this group.
I didn't think of them. I listened to this album several times, and I never thought of Led Zeppelin. I just never did.
I mean, I don't know. There's been comparisons to Black Sabbath as well. I see that more than Led Zeppelin, just because it's labeled as or categorized as stoner rock or psychedelic rock, and
I could definitely see that. Yeah.
So I agree with that. Definitely stoner rock.
Right.
Kind of, and I like that.
I do too.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
I like to get out there.
Here we go. All right, so one thing I would like for you guys to comment on, of course comment on the album, and if you're Wolfmother fans, you know, leave us your comments and your thoughts on your opinion on them. But also for bourbon drinkers, whiskey drinkers, whatever, it'll all get you messed up. But leave your comments on if you like this, or if you have something that you like better that we can try on another video. And also, while you're commenting, don't forget to give us a thumbs up on this video. That would really help us out. We really appreciate the feedback. And whether it's good or bad, we appreciate the feedback. So.
Right. Tell us what we could do better. Tell us what...
Absolutely.
What you want to see us do.
Yeah.
We won't do everything you want us to, but...
Well,
James is pretty cheap.
I don't know. We'd have to discuss that. All right. So, highball. What do you think?
I like the highball.
You like it straight? Like it better?
I like it straight as well.
Yeah.
But I like the highball because I don't know. It's just it's good. It's a little bit sweet. Mm-hmm. I'm not that into really sweet drinks.
Yeah.
But. I like it.
Well, I'm going to say something else, and some people may just absolutely cringe and roll their eyes, but this is also not bad making, you know, bourbon balls during the holidays. It's really good for that.
I love some bourbon balls.
I do, too. I love bourbon balls.
I want to eat at least three of them and fill a buzz, though.
Yeah.
How much bourbon I want in my bourbon balls.
Some of the best bourbon candy I ever had was at the Wild Turkey Distillery. I went up there a few years ago, and they had some little chocolates. And man, it was just great. I don't know what or how they made it. Of course, they made it with Wild Turkey, maybe Rare Breed. I'm not sure, but it was excellent. So for those of you who may want to go to Wild Turkey and they have chocolate, try the chocolate. It's really good. They still have it. So awesome. You ever been to Wild Turkey?
Never.
It's great.
I want to take this show on the road.
We should. If we could find somebody that would allow us to go to their place and do that, that'd be awesome. So Wild Turkey, if you're watching, it'd be awesome to get an invite from you. So.
Right.
All right, so...
we'll just crash the place.
We should. We should just go in and, you know, just crash it and let them kick us out, I guess.
That would
make for a good video.
We'll do our thing and then until they tell us to leave.
Right. So I said that Witchcraft is my favorite song on the album. What's your favorite song?
I like Joker and the Thief.
Very good song.
It's my
as well.
Favorite. Also, White Unicorn. I do really like Witchcraft. And I really like The Single Woman.
Mm-hmm.
It is kick-ass.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
All the songs are great, though.
Yeah. Yeah, they're all it's a solid album. Absolutely. Or we wouldn't be doing it.
Right.
Well, I don't know. We might do it if it was a bad one. We did do Milli Vanilli.
So. Yeah, has been suggested that we do some bad albums. But why listen to bad music?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It sucks. You guys don't want to listen to us or watch us
maybe
talk
we can,
about bad albums.
Maybe we could talk about an album we disagree about.
I'm sure
one
I have
think,
a couple.
One that I think is good, you think is bad, or vice mm-hmm. versa.
Right. I'm sure I have a couple on my shelf that he wouldn't like, and he's probably got some on his shelf that I wouldn't like. So we'll have to compare those.
All mine are good.
and all mine are good as well. So we're going to flip this over. We'll be right back. All right, so we're back, and again, we're listening to Wolfmother and drinking some highballs with some Canada Dry and some Eagle Rare. So we flipped this record over. What's this song right here, Keith?
This is Apple Tree.
Apple Tree. And then the next song is Joker and the Thief, which is your favorite song. So let's go ahead and rate some stuff. So album, rate it.
I'll give it a 4.
You'll give it a 4?
Solid 4.
I'll give it a 3.5. I don't like the album. There's one side of the album that's got some acoustic stuff and kind of like some dance mix stuff on it. That I wasn't too big into whenever I listened to it, so when I have listened to it after that, I kind of skipped that part.
That's not part of the original album release.
Right.
This is a 10th anniversary album, and it has bonus tracks on it.
Yeah.
The bonus tracks, and I agree, some of those are kind of, remixed
one,
by other people.
Right, so there's one on here, Woman, is, I guess, the Mastercraft remix.
Yeah.
And I mean, I don't know. I mean, I guess it's got its place. I'm just not
the Vagabond
not a big
acoustic
fan.
Isn't bad.
No, it's not. It's not, but it's all on that same side. And Right. But I'd give it a 3.5 with that. Without it, I'd probably give it a 4. You know, of course, I've got to be difficult in my rating, so, you know.
Go right ahead. I pulled that stuff out.
All right, so the bourbon, straight.
As far as bourbons, this is the best one I've ever had. 5 out of 5 stars.
5 out of 5 for him on that. And then I would also give it a 5 out of 5. It's one of my, I have several favorite bourbons, but this is definitely high up on the list. This, I also am a big fan of Woodford Reserve and Knob Creek. Those are both affordable, very good bourbons. I don't go on high end stuff. It's going to be affordable, or I'm not going to drink it unless somebody gives it to me. So,
yeah.
So straight, I give it a 5 out of 5. I like it with the ginger ale. That's really about the only thing I really drink it mixed with. I don't do a lot of dark colas, period. I mean, I just don't drink a lot of them. And so ginger ale is the only thing I can rate it with the mix. And I would give it, I guess I'd give it a 5 out of 5 too, because I drink ginger ale like shit, crazy. All the time I drink ginger ale. It's the only kind of soda I drink. So high marks on both for the rare breed for me, so.
I hardly ever drink sodas.
Yeah.
But I like it. Mm-hmm. It works.
I agree. It does the job. I hear a rumbling. You hear that? Maybe it's the speakers.
Maybe it's children's.
I do have children upstairs, so maybe it's them running around. I don't know. All right. So what else do we have to say?
We have to say check us out on Instagram.
Yes.
Also Facebook.
Yep.
Give us a like and follow us.
Yep.
And I don't think we have anything else to say.
I would just say leave the comments below and, again, tell us what you'd like to see from us in our next videos, music you'd like for us to listen to, alcohol, or, maybe it's not alcohol, anything you'd like for us to drink and try out, leave that as well. But leave those comments, give us a thumbs up. Follow us on all the social media sites that we have so far. We're still on Twitter.
Yep,
we still have a Twitter. So look for us on Twitter. All right. So I guess that's it. So a quick wrap up on this is some good damn bourbon and some good music. So if you've not checked either one of these out, go get a bottle, go pick this up and listen to it and enjoy it. And that's all I've got to say.
All right. We'll see you later.
All right. Bye, guys.
Peace.
That shit wasn't right. Fucking smooth.
Right.